Minasan, Okarinasai. Today, someone who is simultaneously a sweet little angel, but also a chaotic mad dog, Kaori Maeda, born April 25th, 1996, in Kita, Kyushu, within the Fukuoka Prefecture, part of the amazing Amuse Inc. agency. As a child, she was interested in fantasy and would write stories while she was in elementary school. Her interest in voice acting began when she read the manga Voiceover Seiyuu Academy, and she was also influenced by her enjoyment of plays from an early age. Prior to her debut, she even used to be the lead singer of a band back in her hometown. In 2016, she won the Grand Prix in the Seiyuu Artist Development Program selection. This would also lead to her debuting into anime the very same year, having a bunch of minor roles in the show 100% Pascal Sensei, but also Arya Futaba in Aikatsu Stars. Pretty big for a debut year. She would even reprise this role in the future for a few episodes in Aikatsu on Parade. Skipping 2017 and right into 2018, she voiced Mari in Backstreet Girls, her first main character, joining the seiyuu unit Goku Dolls Nijigumi, with Yuka Nukui and Hikaru Akao, more tiny ladies. Look at this fantastic cover though, real shame they only had one song. But also the biggest thing of her career, joining another group known as Niji. Specifically Love Live, voicing Shizuku Osaka in the game version for now, becoming part of the Nijigasaki School Idol Club, and later their subunit Azuna. This year, she would also join Pretty Derby as Nice Nature. Aside from all this, she voiced Selka in Sword Art Online Alicization. 2019, she joined yet another multimedia project, Kimono Friends, as Giant Panda. Giant is definitely not the word I would use to describe Maeda, but maybe that's why she auditioned for this role. But aside from this, voicing in popular shows like We Never Learn as Inomori and Dr. Stone as Sapphire. Then a smaller role of Yuzu in Kandagawa Jet Girls. 2020 is the year of the rat, and also her zodiac. She actually fits the mouse image quite well, or even just a rat since she is very feisty. She was in the highly controversial show Interspecies Reviewers as Thies, and then two leads, the first one being the Nijigaku anime where she voiced Shizuku again, but also Yomi in the baseball show Tamayomi, singing the ending with the rest of the team. 2021 was a really good year for her. Crystal Celeste in Combatants Will Be Dispatched, shoutouts to the banger opening. Shoko in Nighthead 2041, Mimimi in Platinum End, and another lead of Kanaho in the Assault Lily spinoff. However, she did properly join the series the prior year in a stage play. The next year of 2022, her first and so far only photo book, Otana no Kaori. Then as for anime, a smaller year, having Momo in Onipan, Caroline in Bibliophile Princess, and the small character Lily in RPG Real Estate. Oh, also a lead of Toka in Miss Koreitsu from the Monster Development Department. Then 2023 was another amazing year for her, probably her best ever. She debuted as a solo artist with her EP, Mikensai Star, the lead track, Toward the Shining Coin, being the opening for Saving 80,000 Gold in Another World for My Retirement, also voicing Sabine. Other anime include Sumi in Demon Slayer, Let's Go Maeda, Eruka in Summoned to Another World for a Second Time, Orihara in the second season of Nagatoro, Jesse in the second season of Tonikawa, Stacy in Reign of the Seven Spellblades, Natalia in I'm Giving the Disgraced Noble Lady I Rescued a Crash Course in Naughtiness. I'm sure this is a great show. Also, what's with all the English names? Aside from these, she had another lead of Lexia in I Got a Cheat Skill in Another World and became unrivaled in the real world too. Funny enough, Akarin is also in this and her character is named Kaori. Missed opportunity there. I did skip over a few, but this year was her biggest in terms of anime, having 14 different roles. And aside from all that goodness, her alongside the other Nijigaku girls won the singing award at the 17th Seiyuu Awards. 2024, this year, she is currently in The Way of Pwn, voicing Nashiko, and singing the opening with the other leads. She also has another lead of Haruka in Gushing Over Magical Girls. That is me, definitely me, the show was made for me. Definitely gotta watch this. At some point, she will have 2.5 Dimensional Seduction as one of the leads, again playing opposite to Akarin. Then again with her and the rest of the crew, they will have Nijion Part 2 and Part 1 of the Nijigasaki movie trilogy. So that's it for her main career, let's move on to some other things. Over the years, she has had minor roles in shows like Fruits Basket, The Great Cleric, Ahiru no Sora, Love and Lies, Danmachi Season 2, Anime Gatari, Is This the Order of the Rabbit Season 2, Million Arthur, and Slime Diaries. Aside from the Backstreet Girls seiyuu unit, she has been part of other groups that were only active for a short period of time, like Zero Tick Holic for Show by Rock, and Kiara Terzet for Kiara Fantasia, which are both video games. Speaking of, other video games include anime tie-ins like Kanagawa Jet Girls, Pretty Derby, and Love Live, also the Show by Rock and Kiara Fantasia groups, But apart from these, she's got Azure Lane, King's Raid, Cookie Run Kingdom, Dead or Alive Extreme Venus Vacation, and Assassin's Creed Mirage. There's even a game coming out in late February called Saifuku Kanojo. Live concerts include all six main Nijigasaki Lives, the Shuffle Fest and their Tokimeki Fan Meet Tour, Ozuna's Solo Live as well as their Fan Meet event, the Love Live 9th Anniversary Festival, the Countdown Live, and the recent Ichigan Collab Festival with Idolmaster. Then being at Anisama with the other original 9 members in 2019, as well as one of the 3 representatives at the Bushiroad 15th Anniversary in 2022. Over with Pretty Derby, she's been at their 3rd live on day 2, the 4th live for both Tokyo shows but only day 1 of Yokohama, as well as the extra Baluna Dome show, and lastly, both days of the Nagoya show for the recent 5th live, which I highly recommend that you watch. Parts 3 and 4 of that recent tour will be in early February and late March, but I'm not sure if Maeda is confirmed for either of them, but I would heavily assume that she'll be at least one of those shows. As for stage plays, she's been in Assault Lily, League of Gardens, which I'm pretty sure is the only time she performed with them, and that's very odd. But she's also performed live with Kimono Friends, I assume for a stage play, but I just can't find the exact details. So let's move on to the fun facts, of which I have a fair amount. She is the shortest Love Live Seiyu at 146 centimeters or 5'9½". You gotta include that half part, so she seems just a little bit taller. She has both Twitter X and Instagram, as well as both for her radio program, Maeda Strategy. She's actually a part of a few radio programs, even having one with the very lovely Miyu Tomito over on Onsen Radio. She often appears on the Dengeki Gaming YouTube channel, and is part of a Seiyu Esports team, also having its own YouTube channel. Mayu and Natsumi from Niji, as well as Riko Kohara over in Bandori, are also part of this unit. Well, it's more of a team, not a unit. Then her fan club is Kaori Kingdom. She actually used to host a program called Furuhata Maeda and Nishizake. That last word is like a term for bonding over drinks, and she co-hosted with SKE48 member Nao Furuhata. Kaori really likes to play games and even plays a fair amount of PC games, specifically loving FPS shooters. She's also a big fan of all those super depressing shows like Angel Beats, Clannad, and Little Busters. And she also enjoys watching foreign drama and just anime in general. She's very passionate about alcohol like many other Nichi girls, but I think she is the most passionate in the whole group. Her go-to beer was actually Corona, though she jokes that she may have to change that up now. Aside from being an amazing performer, she is skilled in mahjong, basketball, badminton, and pitching, showing off that last one in some Love Live baseball collabs. Her childhood nickname was Maidengomushi, a play on her last name, and Dengomushi, meaning pill bug. Honestly, very fitting. While on Chami's Snack Club, she revealed that she is freaked out by Hello Kitty, the cutesy children's franchise. One time Shu and Homan saw her on a train, and this was way before they were all really close, they came up to greet her, and then later she was wondering how they recognized it was her through the mask, but then she realized it was because of her height. I mention this because I also always know it's her because of how not gifted she is in the height department. I'm pretty sure in America if you're under 4'10" you are legally a dwarf, so big F for Kaori. She's been in a few commercials over the years, one for 7-Eleven that actually also promoted Pretty Derby, and another one which of course poked fun at her height where she got mistaken for a child. And actually now that I think about it, I'm pretty sure this was the exact same commercial. Also, she previously worked part-time at a Mr. Donut store. Hey, I too work at a donut shop. Last few things here, she claims that she can sleep anytime, anywhere. She is an only child. Is ambidextrous, meaning she can use both hands fairly evenly, not really having one dominant. Is actually pretty good at drawing, though she doesn't show it off often. And she has been known to flip off the camera on multiple occasions. Also, there is an adult video star with the exact same name, though she is a fair amount older than Kaorin. Oh, and shout out to the time that she crashed Harumoe's dance practice. The last thing I just want to mention, when Tomori left Niji, Kaori definitely took it the hardest, and you could really feel the power of their friendship during their final live and final stream together. Hopefully they maintain a nice close friendship as the years go on. And with that we have reached the ending. Maeda actually has way more roles than I initially thought. She was really out there in 2023. Really happy for her. Hoping her singing career takes off and she gets more relevant roles in more popular shows in the future. Thank you so much for watching, I hope you've enjoyed and learned something new. Please join me in the next one about a very beautiful guitarist in Bang Dream. I look forward to seeing you there.